Now that we have both a turbine overview display and turbine detail display, we would like to have a way to jump directly from the overview display to the detail display. We would also like this link to be able to automatically pass the context of the overview display to the detail display. This way, we can use our on-screen navigation collections to select a turbine we are interested in and have a link that opens up the detail display and automatically adjusts the context to be the turbine we were looking at. This can be done by leveraging PyAF and templates to create an attribute on our turbine element that can be used to link to our turbine detail display. That link can use vision URL parameters to adjust the context of the details display. To get started with this, we can minimize Chrome and open PySystem Explorer by using the shortcut on the desktop. Once opened, we can select the Library tab in the bottom left. This is where all of our AF templates are defined. We want to make our navigation link attribute on our turbine template, so this attribute can be applied to all turbines. In the Element Template section, you can see we have templates configured for each level of our AF hierarchy. We have a template for our region, farm, and turbines. Let's select the turbine template. And now, go to Attribute Templates. Here, we can see all the attributes that are set on the turbine template. This means that every element created using this template will have all of these attributes. We can also see that we have an attribute called Details URL. This is the attribute we will use to create the link to the turbine details display. To create this link, we will change our data reference to URI Builder. The URI Builder data reference is a good choice for this because it will provide us a UI for building out our PyVision URLs. Now we can click Settings to get started setting this up. Here, we can paste in our URL to our PyVision Turbine Event Details display. We can grab that by going back to Chrome and copying the URL from the address bar. Now we can hit continue. You can see the UI automatically separates our Vision website URL and our display. This will be done provided we have PyVision selected as the type. To change the asset context with the URL, we're going to use the asset URL parameter. For its value, we need something that will represent the full path to the turbine element that we're using for the new context. This can easily be done by leveraging substitution parameters to build out the full path to the element. %System% represents the name of the AF server, %Database% represents the name of the database, and %ElementPath% is the path to the element. Once everything looks correct, we can press OK to define the attribute. You may notice there's a second attribute called DetailsURLYesterday. The purpose of this attribute is to not only update the asset context, but to also change the time of the display to be the previous day. To define this attribute, we can change the data reference to URI Builder just as before. Then we can click Settings, and here again paste our URL to our PyVision Turbine Events Details display. Then, in addition to our asset parameter, we can add a start time parameter. And set its value equal to Y, which corresponds to yesterday at midnight. To update the end time, we can add another parameter called end time and set that equal to T, which corresponds to today at midnight. To define the attribute, we can press OK. Now, let's check in these changes and save them, which will push them out to all of our turbines. Now that we have created these attributes, let's test them out in our vision displays. To do this, we can first minimize System Explorer and go back into Chrome. Then we can open our overview display. And now we can make an asset comparison table for these new attributes. When making the asset comparison table, it's recommended to make it using the same element that's already selected on the display. So for this display, our context is already set to NY001. So I'll go there and select my new attributes. Now, let's try changing the context of the display and using these links to open the event details display. I'll change this from New York to Philadelphia and select turbine PH001. Before navigating away, I'll make sure to save my display. And now, I'll click one of these links. You can see that the events details display opened up with the same context as the overview display, and now we are looking at the event frames from turbine PH001. If we go back to the overview display, we can also try the details URL yesterday attribute. You can see again we passed the correct context, and we also changed our start time to midnight yesterday and end time to midnight today. You probably noticed that when these attributes got pulled in, we see this icon. This indicates that it's a URL, which means everything's working as expected. I encourage you to check out other URL parameters in the URL parameter reference in the PyVision documentation, and try those out on your displays.